I was sitting in an Outback Steakhouse in Burleson, Texas. Burleson, Texas is the home of both Kelly Clarkson and Jessica Simpson. That has nothing to do with the rest of the story, but that's where they're both from. And as I'm sitting in this Outback Steakhouse, some friends of mine and I had ordered this thing. It's an appetizer, and it's very famous at Outback. It's really well known. It's called a bloomin' onion. Anybody ever had the bloomin' onion? When you say it in Australia, it stands for upset stomach, because I, in that moment, felt this woo-to-woo in my tummy, tum-tum, and I stood up because I had a brand new purpose in life, and I scurried across the Outback Steakhouse floor, and I walked through the bloodstore, and when I walked through, moved by purpose, I realized that there were two stalls in there, and both stalls were shut and locked, and nobody was in either one. But I was moved by purpose, which would be on the other side of the door. So I began to look around the room, trying to process what I'm going to do to get from point A to point B. Because my purpose is to be on the other side of the door. I really needed to be on the other side of the door. So my very first plan was pretty simple. I'm walking up to the door, wiggling my fingers, trying to wiggle my finger between the door and pop the latch. Wiggle my fingers, pop the latch. If you've ever tried to break into anything in life, you realize that this is not simply a hand thing. This is your entire body. Like, I'm twisting and shouting and sort of like, go get it. I'm trying to get my fingers between the door to pop the latch. It's not happening. I look around the room trying to find something to help me. Maybe an object. I notice there's a boomerang super glued to the wall. And I walk over to the boomerang and I begin to try and pry out the boomerang from the wall. And as I'm prying at the boomerang, I am holding it with all that I have, yanking with all that's within me, have my foot pressed against the wall trying to take the boomerang. And I don't know, maybe I was just nervous, but in my head I thought this: what if they have cameras in this restroom? Very shortly after that, I was relieved, because it is illegal to have cameras in a restroom. But I'm going to be honest with you guys tonight, I'll let you know that I don't know what I would have done with that boomerang if I'd gotten it off the wall. But I looked around the room and I looked for something to help me out, because you need something. And I look and I notice there's a basket full of napkins sitting on the sink. And I take the napkins out of the basket, put them to the side. I walk back over to one of the doors with the basket, and I begin trying to jump, swing the basket, and pop the latch. I jump, swing the basket, pop the latch. Simple in my head, thinking it's going to work in my head. Jump, swing the basket, pop the latch. That's all you need to do. So I'm doing that, and there are two major problems with this. One is that I'm rhythmically challenged. I can't do anything with any type of timing whatsoever. I'm stinking EDR, I stink at Guitar Hero, all that stuff I'm terrible at. So it's not like I can time this right. Second problem is this: just because I need to be on the other side of the door, my arm does not grow 3 feet when I jump and swing a basket. So I'm looking around the room, I realize my situation, and I realize, I'm being honest with myself, I've got one or two options. I'm either going over, or I'm going under. I look at the Outback Steakhouse restroom floor, and I cut those options down to one. I'm going over. The plan was simple. I'm taking two steps, grabbing a hold of the bar, which was above the door with my G.I. Joe Kung Fu grip, and I'm shimmying over the door like Spider-Man. So that's exactly what I tried to do. I took my two steps, I grabbed the bar, death grip on the bar, and I began to shimmy. The thing was, it was Sunday, and when you go into church on Sundays, typically you have slick shoes on. So the bottom of my shoes were very, very slick. I'm getting no traction whatsoever. So instead of shimmying over the door, I'm just banging against this door over and over. I look at the Outback Steakhouse restroom floor, and I revisit under. Now my final plan was pretty simple. Two steps, head first slide, and I'm going in second place. Boom. Up. Boom. Up. So that's exactly what I did. Head first. Boom. There was no up. And I am laying in the middle of a restroom floor, squiggling like a salamander. I got about belt deep, and I looked, and there's someone sat in front of me. People who laugh don't pay attention, because I told you no one was on the other side of the door. But I did get about belt deep, and I heard someone open the door behind me. And when I looked back at him, he had the most puzzled look on his face. Like, oh, really? Really? Can you not not just ask the lady at the front. It's a great question. I was trying to get out of the door because I had a reason to be on the other side of the door. There was a purpose in me being on the other side of the door.